Hello there, my fellow Pythonistas. In this video, we are going to type my password incorrectly. But after I have successfully logged into my CentOS machine, what we are going to take a look at is what you can do about security in Python. What are the facilities provided by Python to secure your code and create more resilient applications? So first of all, we would like to have a console terminal, and also we would like to have a Firefox web browser. So this video is going to be about the module called safety in Python, and technically, this module lets you, so to speak, create more secure or resilient code with the help of Python. So pypi.org, and here we are going to look for the safety module. So safety module got to my attention when I was watching the recent PyCon videos. You should check them out because they are awesome. So if you visit the homepage, you will see that this module is available on GitHub. And technically what it will do is to technically create or analyze your let's navigate the pyup.io, and here we would like to get to the safety. I said safety. And basically what it will do is to analyze your code against known vulnerabilities. There is a free tier account and the paid tier account. So the difference between the two of them is that you technically, when you have a free tier account, you have access to a database that is updated once a month, and it allows you to run this safety module. And by running this safety module, it will analyze your requirements .txt against known vulnerabilities. So what I mean by this is going to be trivial. If we go to the github.com/reaperpy, and here I have some repositories, and these repositories are going to be looking like this. So I think I have a Udemy repository, and what I would like to do now is to first of all increase the font size of my console, because lots of you have complained about that I do not really provide, hold on, let me arrange this, so I do not really provide a decent size of console text, and you cannot see the videos. So now that we have gotten out this of the way, we will git clone the repository, and once we did that, we will navigate to the Udemy repository. Here you can see that this is a fully fledged Python module that you can access from the PyPI, and this is basically allowing you to interact with the Udemy's API query or courses and so on. So I have a previous video about that. You can check it out. Now, if we get back to our module, what we can do is to technically install this with the PyPI. And after we have installed it, so Python 3.7-m pip install safety, and I think it will fail because I didn't specify the --- user, but we will see. Yeah. So now let's try it. Oh, we cannot start. dash user this way. Unknown option. Good lord. So Python 3.7 dash m pip install safety. And while it installs, let me pull up another console. And now here we are in the Udemy folder. So once this is installed, what you can do and should do is to issue the safety whitespace check command. And this will check your, let's say, requirements, which are specified in the requirements txt or by the setup.py as requirements, and it will check the versions against its own database and provide you with the feedback if there are any known vulnerabilities to a specific version of the module that you are using in your Python application or module. And technically that was all I wanted to show you, so I'm really hyped to know about this module and I would like to incorporate it in my daily life. Thank you for watching.